Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I'm rendering exposition of Luke 19, verse 45 onward. So I did the other part. Jesus cleanses the temple, and he entered the temple and began to drive out those who sold, saying to them, "It is written, my house shall be a house of prayer, but you have made it a den of robbers." And he was preaching and not teaching daily, clarifying the corruptions in the Torah in the temple. Jesus was a preacher, you know, he's a superior to moral teachers, because he's the royal priest and moral teachers are priests. So he knew the inside out of everything, Torah. So he was preaching with authority. The chief priest and the scribes and the principal men of the people were seeking to destroy him, but they did not find anything they could do, for all the people were hanging on his words. Now the people were trusting him, you know, because he was preaching it with great authority, so they dare not touch him, you know, because his preaching was far superior and authoritative than the rabbi could do. He explained every root of the Torah in details and with authority, as I try my best. Now, this temple was made by human hands. It is like synagogue. And these temples are places, are the schools. You know, we send children to school to learn letters and other things. So same the way, temple was also a school of theology, where the student learned Torah and the religious education. Remember, Saul was the disciple of Gamaliel, one of the Pharisees, and he was well known in society. So he learned every bit of that thing in detail. But as the Pharisees, they were themselves blind. They lacked the knowledge of oral Torah, which Jesus had. So that is why, you know, Jesus was preaching with authority and everyone was spellbound. So, the rabbis, when they were good, as the Samaritan village rabbis were good at that time too, Samaritan woman at the well, she was the product of their rabbi. And in spirit she wetted Christ Jesus and told him that you are a prophet. And when Christ come, he will tell us everything. So Jesus was so happy with her that he disclosed himself to her. And these men of letters are the Jewish people. They hate Samaritans. And even today, these men of letters, the five husbands, they were spiritual. Immorality, anger, greed, worldly temptation, and haughtiness of the knowledge of the Torah, book knowledge, haughtiness. Samaritan woman had learnt it by spirit. So this was the fifth husband of the Samaritan woman, no more dominating her, because she learnt it by spirit. She was humble, and living with her, no more dominating her. So she was a most pious woman, and the men of letters call her She was a prostitute. She was marrying one husband after the other. Even I go to Oxford Theology and explain to them, these are their names. They say, no, no, no. In our book, it's written in the Bible, she married one husband after the other. And she was a bad woman. And as the story is made in the Bible by the Messianic Jews, they stick to that one. They are brainwashed. These five are well known to the six of the second anointed Christ, Nanak. So the six of the first anointed Christ, Jesus, Sikh means student. So they have no knowledge of this one. That is why the second one came. So these brick-built temples, which was synagogues and all that, they were made by human hands. And they put a human person in there to teach them the moral law, which pertained to body and not to soul. And they kept the Yahweh alienated from the disciple. They said, he is somewhere in heaven. We don't know. You should not know it. You can't write his name. He is so pious. He is Lord. He is Lord and God. That's why these rabbis, they were Lord for the disciple. They used to call them, rabbi used to be very happy when the disciples called them father. As you have these Catholic fathers, you know, similar one. So these Catholic fathers, they are the copycat of those rabbis. Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. The added temple spirit, added people who were sacked from the temple, they could not find a job. You remember Jesus said, the wine press is given to the husbandmen, and they did not produce fruit. That fig tree had no fruit, beautiful leaves, beautiful temple, no fruit. So it was died. So the temple was destroyed. One stone won't be left on top of the other. So in this temple, which was made by human hand, for the natural men who were disciples of the rabbi, they were saying prayers and fasting and meditation. Meditation is on the oral Torah. We meditate on oral Torah. We don't pray or fast. This is the temple of God, made not by human hand, but by nature. Inside you meditate or intuition over his word and you get it. It is inside you. You can get it with the grace of our Father. So the temple was destroyed. Priests became useless. So they have been replaced by royal priests, which are we. Superior to these dog-collared people who are replacement of those rabbi. They are antichrist. So that is why you have sectarian riots and all that trouble in the world. And the second anointed Christ came in India in the name of Nanak. And over there, the people of Khatri tribe were the most greedy person in the world. If you want to know the epicenter of the sons of Satan, it is the Punjab. People tell lies, hypocrite, you will be surprised, you know, and many people go there from Britain to Amritsar to pay homage, and how they are treated, how they are cheated. When they come out, they tell the stories that how the rabbis over there, we call them Granthi, how they rob and cheat people for the sake of money. They want money, money, money. So the holiest of holy is this golden temple. The Khatris, when they got this under their control, they put gold on it, gilded it, to make it look nice. The once-born person, he just want to see the brickwork, the leaves, fig tree leaf, beautiful leaves, no fruit, beautiful temple in Jerusalem, no fruit. Same, this beautiful temple now, holiest of holy, is the same size as the holiest of holy that used to be in Jerusalem, golden temple, and same size. It could have been built bigger, but no, same size, so that people know that this is the replacement of the holiest of holy from Jerusalem. Such things you can't convince to people. They are received on individual basis. And 1 in 1,000 and 2 in 10,000 are Christ in Jesus. In Jesus, you Christians are people of the book. They don't know Christ Jesus. Only the Christ know the Christ. Christian cannot know. Because if Jesus was of the person of the book, he could have written the New Testament. But New Testament is oral Torah, cannot be written down in ink on paper. So what is written down, they corrupted it. But now we have got the Gnostic Gospel, which are far better. And they came out at the right time in 48. And now we have the opportunity to understand gospel and everything. Everything happens according to the will of our Father. And now they are bundled up for a final burning. Matthew 13:24-30. Parable wheat and tare is taking place. So this is the final prophecy that is to be left. Second coming of Jesus had taken place in 1469. Nani came in. They preached gospel for 150 years. Because gospel is for men of spirit. And by men of spirit, know the other men of spirit. Spirit can talk to spirit as flesh to flesh. Written Torah, these people can read and understand because it's letters. But oral Torah, New Testament, is spirit, only for the men of spirit and not for these university theologians of the letters. I call them super donkeys carrying holy books. So here you are, end of the time is near, so try to please preach gospel and try to make t-shirts so that these are lamps on living lampstand. People may laugh at you, people may try to mock you, don't worry. You are doing it with authority, they have no authority. If you ask them simple question, they have no base. People can ask you question, you can answer it, but they can't. So, don't worry. Our Father is inside us. We are having Emmanuel. Our Father God blesses you.